Now we're going to try this again. Okay. So for whatever reason, my apologies there, chat. It looks like for whatever reason, my entire OBS studio just locked up. It's like the third time it's done it to me in like 2 or 3 days. I have a feeling that it's having some issues. Hopefully, whatever they are, the folks that make OBS Studio will get it taken care of. And it'll all be back to normal before you know it. So, we are back, and we are going to continue moving forward where... I think we've actually got one of the derelict reclaimers to do. Which I'm not going to lie at all. Super, super excited about that. I have not seen nor done one yet. Today will be my first one. Guess maybe while I'm up here, I should go ahead and get the 890 jump taken care of first, because, you know, they're always complaining about everything. UDM, retrieval op, these are the data. Oh, yeah, I don't have an 890. Ah, there's an 890. Okay, so we're going to do the 890 real quick, because the 890 is, like, my favorite one. As soon as we do that, we're immediately going to switch over to... Was the 890? Other side of the planet. Of course it is. Why wouldn't it be? You don't expect me to get that lucky, do you? Is that my right? That is not an OM. There's my OM. When you're looking for an OM in that line, always look for the biggest one. Biggest diamond will get you where you're going. Okay, so this should reset my noise.
Quantum travel complete.
And it did. Thank you. 890 is over there. So reach up here.
Quantum travel.
So this is self status, shields, power, target status. I'm coming for you, 890. I'll save you. No, that's that 8. No, I wanted the 890. Oh god, I think I... There now seems to be a space station in my way. I need the space station out of my way. That's better. Much better.
Quantum travel complete.
Let's see if this is one of the yes you do have or no you do not have to cut lie type of missions. There's one. Waiting for him to wake up. Wait for him to wake up. There he goes. It has not caught on yet. Need to be very, very careful. Looks like the mission is taking some time to start up. And there he moves. Mission still hasn't started up yet.
Crap.
Oh, why is this not? There we go. balloon just bumped me.
Shit.
Going on here.
Attack on shields.
I have three of them actually.
Son of a bitch.
This is a Mustang here.
Target destroyed.
Where the hell did the Mustang come from? Quote-unquote helping me. Because if he gets in my line of fire, I must deal with him as well.
Target destroyed.
Now watch him tell me to stop. Well, that was rather exciting. Now that I am here, and I've whooped on the bad guys. It is now time to free the hostages, which there are none, because they're all dead, but still, you get the idea. I would free the hostages if there were any. My body inside the planet is down there mocking me nonstop. Nothing on that side. Up to the bridge. Take it to the bridge. Oh, there it is. My third spot. Done. That's an extra $5,000 right there. Now I can take my time punishing rest of these guys. Oh, wait, I forgot to do that. There we go.
T-Lox said, Gilded more than Discord.
I do could not agree with you more. Not even a little bit.
Look out! Someone's searching!
Discord is not a bad program. It does very good job of what it does. It just doesn't do as much as Gilded does. I personally do not understand the whole hate for one over the other. You know, either direction. I'm both a Star Wars and a Star Trek fan. I'm both a cake and a pie eater. I like both pirates and ninjas. And while I don't understand why anybody would not eat pineapple on a pizza, I do eat pineapple on all pizzas. As far as the Gilded versus Discord thing, man, that is, if people are happy using the program they're using and they don't want to get something better, fine. No big deal. I just can't understand why you would. My dead body down there. You know what? Actually, I'm going to do this real quick. Put this away. Go into my... Go into here. Go personal. Not personal inventory. No. Actions, layer, Smith's corpse marker. There we go. Can't get to it anyways, so please not just don't have to have it sit there teasing me the entire time. I did miss him. His head moved. How did that guy not die? Or that one? Nobody over here. How you doing today, Tilo? Hope your Wednesday's treating you good. Not a salt person up there for a moment.
T-Lox said, I'm good, boo.
I am not bad at all. Star Citizen has only unfairly killed me a couple times. So as far as I'm concerned, and I haven't had any blockers. So I've only been killed a couple times when I shouldn't have. And I haven't had any blockers at all. To me, that makes it an extremely good day.
Northwind for a Fipsade, hello.
Hey Northwind, how you doing? Open door. Open. I've got people to kill. Or I have people to kill me. Maybe I have people to kill me. And bam. Bam. One more, Ulamas. I'll just look down next to each one of these as I run.
Northwind for a Fipsade. Been thinking about buying the game, but had people say I should wait for Starfield.
So I will tell you this, and I will be as brutally honest as I possibly can. So you're not going to get any white knighting out of me or anything like that. This is what I will tell you about Star Citizen. Star Citizen is a game that is definitely still in alpha. It is a game that has been under development or in development for 10 years. I backed it 10 years ago for $35. Over the last 10 years, I now have, and I'm not shy about it, I now have 10,000 real life dollars invested into the game. I've done so because I believe in the vision of the guy who made it, and because I have been playing this entire time and have seen the progress of what they've done. So, I'm just giving you everything straight up. I believe that Starfield is going to be an absolutely amazing game. I think it's going to be so good, and I cannot wait for it. I also kickstarted Elite Dangerous. I also kickstarted Dual Universe. I also pre-ordered No Man's Sky. But you're probably kind of getting an idea here that I am sort of a space nerd. Star Citizen, you can get into and play for $45. If you want to, and you have the money, yes, you can spend $40,000 and own every single ship. However, you can also spend $45, own one ship, and then once you own that ship, come in and play the game and be able to earn all the other ships. Why did that door not close? Close the door. There it goes. You can come in and play the game and earn anything you want. You can earn the money to buy all the other games by... Whee! You can earn the money to buy the other game or buy the other ships by doing FPS like I just did right there. You can do it by shooting other ships and being a bounty hunter. You can do it completely without shooting other ships by mining or traveling goods across the universe. There are all kinds of ways to make money in this game, and you will be able to earn the money. Now, I, as I told you, have been here since day one, and I have spent quite a bit of my money in this game because I believe in it. I can also say to you that I have put 9,000 hours into this game. Now, I'm talking about what you see me doing right now, playing in the actual game. So you can very easily get your $45 worth out of it. In fact, I would tell you honestly that you can get your $45 out of it before Starfield even comes out. The other thing that I think that everybody's forgetting about Starfield, again, I'm pre-ordering it and we'll be playing the crap out of it. I've also played everything else Bethesda's ever made. Bethesda is known... Where are we going here? Pick up a package at New Babbage. Okay, we'll go up here first. Bethesda is known in the gaming industry and among gamers as never once ever putting out a full game. And what I mean by that is 144, that is 151. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out where I'm gonna go next. We'll go to New Babbage and go from there. The problem with that is that any time that Bethesda puts out a new game, that game is released full of bugs and errors and issues. Now, we're not talking about a game like Star Citizen where they say, hey, we're still building the game, we're still working on the game, you're going to find all kinds of bugs and stuff because there's bugs and stuff we're working on. When Bethesda releases one of their games, they release the full game, like Gone Gold, and it's still full of issues and bugs and stuff. They then look for the community to fix those issues for them through mods. And the community does. I mean, they absolutely do every time. So the community will always fix all those issues and stuff, which is great. However, you're still going to be getting a buggy game. Now, does Star Citizen have bugs? Absolutely. So many bugs. I mean, just so many. But they're still under development. So if you decide that you wanted to back Star Citizen now for $45, you can log into the game right now, right next to me, in your ship that you own, and play exactly what you see me playing right now. So I'm going to show you some, I'll just show you some of the gameplay and let you kind of see what you think. If you are waiting for Starfield, you're going to be waiting till sometime in next year. And when it does come out, you will have some issues with the game at the beginning. And you will then have a single-player game that you Well, hopefully they're going to add multiplayer. I'm really hoping. But for right now... Oop. Somebody shooting missile at me. Who are you, and why are you shooting missiles at me? Break Cutlass Black. Yep, he's shooting at me. Come on, shoot me one time. Turn red. That's all I need you to do. He's not turning red. Why is he not turning red? There we go, that's what I needed.
Northwind 4 for Psaid. Yeah, I recently started really getting into space games. Got bored of EVE Online and looking for a more modern game.
Ah, I gotcha. Yeah, EVE is definitely... EVE is a really cool game. But it's not so... The problem with both EVE and... the problem with both EVE and Elite Dangerous is they're both games where essentially most of the time you really are just a ship, right? You can't, like, get out and look and feel. In just a moment, give me just a moment here, and I will show you what it's like. So you just saw me fly from space to a planet, then fly into the planet's atmosphere. Now I'm dogfighting on the, really, right? In the atmosphere of the actual planet. And once this jerk is dead... Get this jerk, guys. Oop, oop, oop. I think I'm hurting. Crap, he is hurting me bad. Can't see my own status, but I can tell you that my ship is not very happy with me right now.
Seriously, stop it!
I don't even know how close he is to dead because my MFDs are currently messed up. Come on, die. Oh, no, I just lost an engine. Crap.
Weapons
oh, no, I just lost both my engines. Oh, God. No. No, stop it.
Attack
oh, he's going to kill me. I'm going to try to get out of my ship if I can.
Failure.
Oh, my shields are down. He's still taking me out. Oh, my ship's on fire. I'm blacking out. And I just got destroyed. I did not expect to, encounter something while I was on my way there. Wow. That's a hell of a way to show you Star Citizen.
Northwind 4 of Psaid. Was that a player or an NPC pirate?
That was an NPC. Okay, so I just woke up back in the hospital. Well, I guess now you can see sort of... So this is the FPS portion, right? So in the FPS portion, this is my character. I got to design him the way I wanted. I'm going to take off my medical gown and throw it on the floor because I don't want the medical gown. So there's my medical gown. You cannot see... I'm going to switch views real quick so that you can see what I actually see on my screen. Because if I don't do this, you're not going to be able to see my entire screen. Okay. So what you're looking at up there now is you're looking at my entire monitor. I've got a super ultra-wide monitor. So when I go into my inventory, you can actually see my inventory there. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be getting my guy dressed. So I'm just dragging this undersuit, putting it over top of my guy. Now I've got an undersuit on. I'm just going to double-click a helmet. There's my helmet. Let's see. Here's a chest piece and some arms and some legs. And as you see on the other side, you'll notice there's compartments sort of opening up. Those are the slots on my actual suit. There's a backpack. Did the backpack go on? Yes, it did. Okay, backpack's on. I need a healing gun. I've lost two suits today. Two full suits. That's crazy. Okay, this is... So when you die, they give you what I call the suit of shame, which is this white flight suit. I'm just going to throw it on the ground because I don't want the white flight suit. I got my own, thank you very much. So there's the actual flight suit. The undersuit and the other piece. Let's see. So I need two of these. I'll grab two of these, put them in my legs. I will grab three of these, put them in my chest. This is food and drink that I, or this right here is actually drink that I'm grabbing right now. The other things are healing pins. I will grab a gun and throw it on my back. Put a scope on that gun. And a silencer somewhere up here. There we go, silencer. Grab three med pins. So now you get to see a little bit of the a little bit of the getting dressed part. So one of the big things that Star Citizen offers you that Starfield will not is Starfield is still going to be a game that is linear. So it's still going to be a game that is confined within an area, right? Whereas Star Citizen is a huge game. So to give you an idea, oops, I did not mean to do that. That's my wristwatch there. To give you an idea, in Star Citizen, right now, you can fly from one end of a solar system to another 60 million kilometers, which is a cotton-picking long way. And that's just to get to a moon. Okay, we'll grab 30 of these, throw them in there. Put these on. 1, 2, 3, 4. I need a new multi-tool. Multi-tool on my leg. Put a tractor beam attachment in the multi-tool. Put this on the ground because nobody wants that. And I need an oxy torch. Let's see. Torch in my legs. I'm missing something. What am I missing? Oh, 4 more of these. Or 3 more. 3 more of these. So 3 more of these. There we go. So now my character's all set back up. So now you've seen how that looks. I'm going to go ahead and go back to the larger screen so you can actually see everything. So when I'm in this mode and I go into my inventory, all you get to see is just a little tiny bit of this side here and a little tiny bit of this side here. You don't. So most people, when they're watching me, don't actually know what it is that I'm looking at. Okay, so now that I'm out of the medical center, back on the space station I was on, I'm going to grab a different ship. That was another player that just ran past me. You noticed he was in the suit of shame. So while you're in here, this is a space station I'm in right now. So while I'm in here, I can actually take my helmet off, put my helmet in my bag, walk up here, grab a can of soda. You'll actually see me reach down and grab it. I can then drink that soda. I could lean my head back if I wanted to make it look realistic. You can't see the bar on the right-hand side, but there's a bar letting me know when it's empty. And then I can grab a hot dog while I'm here. And eat the hot dog. And what that does is that actually puts my... You look down here on the right-hand side. Oh, you can't see it very good because I'm... Here, let me put my helmet back on first. Once I put my helmet back on, you'll have the better view again. Okay, so now my helmet's back on. See all these numbers down here? So this is my hydration. This is my food. This is injuries to my body. The temperature of my body. My oxygen, my health, and up above is what's called BDL, or blood drug level. So when you heal yourself, which I can actually do by pulling out this thing and actually stabbing it in my own arm, when I heal myself, it actually increases my blood drug level. And what I can do is I can actually go to the advanced portion of this, and I can choose which one of these different drugs to give myself. So, for instance, one of them I can bring up if I have blindness from being shot in the head, or, for instance, if I'm limping because of my, leg being shot, then I can, you know, put up a different one of them. Most of the time, I just go for straight up healing. Okay, so we're going to grab another ship. We're going to go back down and do the thing we came to do the first time. Since my other ship got destroyed while I'm here,
to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
Go ahead and, now, as I said, I've got a lot of money spent in the game, which is why you see so many ships, because I own a lot of ships.
Welcome.
You know what? Actually, I'll show you one of the two ships that you can get. Let's do that. We're gonna grab the Mustang Alpha. Oh, I need to go ahead and get my Defender claimed. There's insurance in the game, so pretty much what I've done is I've now hired the insurance company
to replace
my ship for me. While that's happening, I'm going to show you one of the two ships that you can get for $45.
Please visit us. Vehicle selected.
I'm going to grab this ship first.
Standby. Vehicle selected. Standby. Your vehicle has been delivered to the following location.
I'm going to Hangar 1. Those are other players, by the way. That over there, that's another player. Okay, so for $45, this is one of the chips that you can get. This is called a Mustang Alpha. I've got a paint job on mine, so mine looks really, really fancy. But essentially, it is a one-person... Don't worry about that, that's just an alpha bug. It is a one-person ship that has cargo capabilities. And what that means is the back right here, you go back here and you click on this. This whole thing here will come down. And this right here is a cargo crate. And you can actually take boxes and stuff, and you can put those boxes inside of this cargo crate. All the way back in here. And then once you've got the cargo crate full, you can put it back up. And it goes back up in the belly. The other ship that you get for $45 does the exact same thing. Well, it still carries four cargo just like this one here does, but it has a different way of doing it. Let me start the ship up for you real quick, and then I will show you what it looks like.
Your journey begins now.
You are clear to launch.
Okay, so he's going to launch me. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go up into the air just a little tiny bit. Now, this is a hangar. So you've seen me go from first person to third person, from first person to ship. So I'm going to go into third person real quick and show you what this thing looks like when it unfolds. So in order for me to put up the landing gear, the wings will actually come down at the same time. And this is what the ship looks like when it's got its wings down and its landing gear up all at once. And like I said, it's a little itty-bitty starter cargo ship. So I, now that I'm out of here, I can... Oh, there's somebody right next to me. Somebody in an eclipse. I wonder what he's doing. Now that I'm out of here, I can actually fly anywhere I want to. So if I wanted to go over there to that light side of the planet, I could. If I want to fly to the dark side of the planet, I could.
Thank you.
Right now, I'm about to go towards the main city, so that I can head back over to get that package. And don't be afraid to ask me any questions you want. I'm always happy to talk about them. So this is the main city of this particular planet. This is called New Babbage. Think of it like an Apple or Google campus. I'll go to third person real quick so you can see it. And let's go here, and then I'll move my camera all the way in. Get an idea of what it looks like. There you go. So that is a giant city, and you can fly down to it. You can fly in it. You can go to the spaceport, which is right there with the red lights. Okay, so I'm going to go back to this package again. Now, as far as I'm aware, I think this is a big old wrecked ship that I have to do some FPS in order to get what I need out of it. Here's what it looks like. Nope, sorry. Here's what it looks like from behind. That is the ship right now. And actually, I can put my camera out so you can actually see it. But yeah, this is the Mustang Alpha. Mustang actually has four different types. Oh, look at the sun's coming up. Perfect.
Contact.
Oh, crap. He's still alive? He is still alive. Okay, I'm going to try. See if I can take him out. Nope.
Let's see what you do with this.
Far is he away from me? 3.1. Yeah, I'm gonna try to take him out with this ship, which is not my normal ship, so we'll kind of see how I do.
Shield hit.
My capacitors are slow.
How do you keep doing that?
He's hurting a little bit. My capacitors keep on running dry because this is a starter ship. He's almost dead. I need to get underneath him. He's got a pretty powerful shield in the front. I'm trying to get behind or below that shield. Just blew off one of his engines. And a front wing. And keep
Seriously,
him off me if I
stop
can.
It.
Almost got him. Wait, did he blow off two of my guns? That's what you get for blowing me up, mister. Okay, so I have supposedly a dead body around here somewhere. Oh, nope, it's up in the air, which probably means anything I haven't. That'll be two of my bodies I've lost today. Maybe if I get lucky, it'll fall to the ground once I get over here. Oh, and it did. Falling. I'll try to follow it all the way to the ground. I might actually be able to pick this up and put it in the ship. Maybe. Pretty much what I'm doing right now is I'm following it to the ground. And it's going a lot faster than me. But if I'm lucky, I'll be able to grab my dead body and take it and put it in my ship. Come on, don't go through. Don't go through. Don't go through. It's ongoing, didn't it? No, I lost another body to the center of the planet. Why? Why did I lose another body? Oh, well. Okay. But now that we're down here, let's go ahead and go pick up the baggage. Man, that makes me angry. Here's what it looks like traveling. Oh, hold on a second, let me put this in the back here. So this planet that I'm on right now is, as you can see, very, very cold. I'll go all the way in so you can kind of see the camera without the ship. See what the world looks like. Is that where I'm heading right there? Hold on one second, I gotta figure out. Oh, that's where I'm going. Okay, so if I'm correct, I now have to get this package from people who may want to kill me. What I'm going to do is I'm going to park back here somewhere.
Landing gear engaged.
Oh, I couldn't even see that tree. Oh, there's trees there. Trees there. I'm gonna go on just on the other side of these trees here and land here.
Engine systems disabled.
Now to see. I can't see anything. I don't know if there's anybody at this position or not. I could be in for a fight. I'm not sure. I'm trying to keep my visor clean if I can. I've got 17 minutes to be able to stay alive because I'm wearing light armor. So since I'm wearing light armor, my visor's starting to freeze over through the during this storm, and I am the edges of my visor are frozen, and I've got 16 minutes and 57 seconds to do whatever it is I got to do and get back to my ship or freeze to death. The longer I'm out here in this area, the worse it's going to get. So it's going to get harder and harder for me to move. I'm going to start shaking uncontrollably. And if I go to third person, you'll notice that my gear is already starting to get super white and cold. I don't see anybody yet. Still hear Walkipedia's music in the background, kind of urging me on a little bit farther. I can't see anyone. I don't know if there's anybody here or not. But I can't see anybody. Don't see anybody moving. There are definitely people here that I can't see because of the snow. What a horrible time. I mean, this is the first one of these I've done since they put them in. Keep wiping my visor. Meanwhile, I still only have 13 minutes before I am. I see a guy there. So I'm going to use my tractor beam, grab this box, and I'm going to send it as far towards my ship as I can. Is that a way I can get out of here? Got 13 minutes left. I'm going to try taking a run. Nobody's after me, that's good. Send this out again. Okay, If it would have been a sunny day, I would have tried to take everybody out. But because it's not and I can't see, I'm not gonna take the chance. Unfortunately, I can't see much because everything's so covered in snow. What do you think, Northwind? Does this seem like a super buggy scam to you so far? You can hear my character starting to freeze slowly.
Come on.
Just want to get in the warmth of my ship. Get this down. Open this up. Grab this. There you go. Put that in there nice and easy.
Northwind Fora from Sade, how good do you need your PC to be to run this game?
So right now, it is more... Oh, did you go in there or not? It is. Right now, it is more... CPU driven than it is GPU. There is a patch that comes out. Okay, hopefully you hear me still breathing. Listen. The warmth of my ship. There is a patch that comes out in the next month.
Engine systems enabled.
And that new patch is going to be bringing Vulcan. And they expect Vulcan to make everything run smoother than it is
landing
right now.
Gear retracted.
But I know lots and lots of people who currently play the game with mid-range PCs. But obviously, it's like everything else. The more mid-range it is, the more you have to turn down the graphics. That's another player who's trying to see what they're doing. This building right
Landing gear engaged.
Land right up close to the door. There we go. Should be pretty good, I think. Nope. On something. There it goes. That's better. So this is one of the two starter ships I was telling you about. This one here has a cockpit, so you have to climb in and out of the cockpit like you would a fighter jet. And you're going to see it close right now. It closes all up. The other one actually has a bit of a cabin to it. And I'll show you that one in just a moment. I did this mission with this one, and I'll do the other mission, the next mission with the other one. Now I got the package. Close that up, I'm done with it. Oh, it doesn't close up. Oh, that's weird. There we go, now it's closed up. Close it back up. Deliver this person's package. I'll get you that that website. Drop off the package and get paid. Give me them space bucks. Quest or contract complete, retrieval op, and awarded 4,000 UEC. Why is my body now saying it's only 40 kilometers away? Oh, oh. Okay, let me grab you that site real quick. Oh, let's see. It is. You want this one right here. Okay, try this website here.
https://robertsbisindustries.com/telemetry
So pretty much what you can do is you can click on however much GPS you want, or sorry, however you could click on however much FPS you want, and then it will give you sort of a range of where everybody's at. So the purple dot is the minimum configuration that people are using, and the orange dot is, I think the orange dot is recommended configuration, and then there is a orange dot which is way across. I'm gonna fly back out there to see if my body's there now. Is it acts like it is? I'd love not to lose two sets today if I can help it. And now you'll be able to see the landscape a little bit better.
Engine systems enabled.
Yeah, I'll show you in third person so you get all. Going the right way? There we go. But you get to see a little bit of the city. Oh, that sun. Can't see. I'm a little bit afraid of, antenna and stuff sticking up right now because I can't see. Switch to the other ship that is the starter ship to show you that one. Those are trees.
M8_4_life_forever said. What paint is that?
That is the blah 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 paint. What's the name of it? I don't remember the name. It was the one they gave us last year during Christmas time. I got one for the Mustang, and I've got one for the Aurora, and it's my favorite paint because it's Diwali colors, which is my org. I absolutely adore both those paint jobs so much. Oh, I think it's called Luminalia paint. I think that's what it's called. It's literally called Luminalia paint. Not 30k. No. Crash. I crashed. No. Hey, is it so? Submit. Now the question is, will I go back into my ship? Because I was so close to the ground, will my ship be in the middle of a mountain somewhere? Guess we'll just have to see what happens. There we go, that's complete. And then launch. Please put me back in my game. Please. Come on, put me back in my ship. Northwind, did that help you? That telemetry site? Did that help you out a little bit? Kind of understanding what you were looking at? I love this Wikipedia music. I'm a fan. Put me back in my ship. Oh, that means I lost all my other missions. No, what? That's my first crash, though. Honestly, that's not too bad. I've played for 8 hours today, nine hours today so far, and that's my first crash. Period. No 30Ks, and that's my first crash. It's not bad. It's not bad at all. And no problems with that. Oh, I'm guessing that I ran into a mountain. That means I've lost three, not one, not two, but three full sets of gear today. This is becoming an expensive day. And in fact, this is the exact same hospital room I was in, because that's where I took off my... Okay. That's where I took off my my gown. And this right here is where I threw out my battery pack down there and my suit of shame. And I do not see a body thing anywhere. Man. Starting to feel like I'm getting robbed here. Not asking for a lot. Just asking for a little bit. Okay, let me go down here. Get rid of the new suit of shame that they've probably given me. I go with the old suit of shame that they gave me. There we go. See, there's my battery I was talking about. Yep. This is the exact same room I was in last time. Okay, time to get redressed. I am running out of suits. I'm going to have to go suit shopping here soon. You would think I've done this before. You know? You would honestly think I've done this once or twice. Put that on there. Put that on there. Put those in my backpack. One of those on me. Four of these. And then 30 more. Three of these. Two more, or three more in my backpack. And I am ready to go again. For the 17th time. Okay, so I guess the good news is now I can show you the other ship that is a starter ship. Oh, here, let me tell you about the paint real quick. As I promised you I would. Go all the way to the bottom. Aurora, yes. It is called Aurora Icebreak. That's what it is. It's Icebreak. It was given to us during Luminalia, but it is Icebreak paint.
Got an accident inbound. It's a pretty big one, so team stand by.
Let me know if there's anything I can help you with.
M8_4_life_forever_said. Eh, okay, coolty.
Yeah, it was given to us for free, not anything that you could buy. I don't know if it's available anymore. I'm sure I probably don't have my missions anymore either. I do. I still have my... What?
M8_4_life_forever_said. It's account bound. Oh shit. There goes the channel. Tunium_just_rated with 4 odd ones.
Ah, Trinium 4. Yep, thank you so very much for that raid. That is very, very kind of you. Oh, nope, that's not working right. Why did it work yesterday morning? That's supposed to work properly. As you can see, it kind of ate. Well, that's the first mistake my bot has had.
Welcome.
I'm definitely going
to
have to
the ASOC vehicle retrieval system.
I'm gonna have to figure that out. Okay, so we are going to retrieve the Alpha, which is now just kind of out there, and I'm going to instead grab the Aurora so that you can see that one. Northwind. I'm going to grab the Aurora down here.
Vehicle selected.
So this is the other starter ship that you can get for $45. Again, I have a skin on it.
Your vehicle has been delivered to the following location.
Hangar 3. So the difference between this one and the other one is the other one looks cooler, but it is a... fighter style with a cockpit. This one here may not look as cool, but it has an actual cabin. So you can actually, so this is what it looks like here. But the difference between this one and that one is that one does not have a bed. This one here actually has a cabin that you can climb up into. And once you're up in the cabin, you are sealed. So you can take off your helmet in space, you can eat and drink, you can put some packages on the floor, and it also has a bed right there. So you can actually climb in it and go to sleep and be able to log off anywhere you want. And that's the two big issues, or the two big changes. Has same number of weaponry, nothing's different like that. Now we're gonna try this one out for the next mission.
Welcome to Robert Space Industries.
You are clear to launch.
Yeah, we do this one.
System check.
So this one here, there's no cool unfolding or anything. It's just pretty much the gear goes underneath, and that's it. And then you got kind of the ship like this. Now, if you remember correctly, I was telling you about the other one and how it's the little thing came out of the belly. This one here, if you notice that black part right there, that's actually where its cargo gets stored. So it's kind of slung underneath on its belly right there. And that's the difference between the two. And of course you can see a difference in sort of the way it's set up as well. Okay, so we are going 4 million away. What exactly is 4 million away? Mike L1.
Thank you, and please visit again.
So we're heading a couple million out so that we can scope out what's there exactly. We're almost to our destination. So this one is the... Perfect. Trying to do a bunch of stuff all at once here. $25,000 away, but oh nope. Wait, what exactly am I doing out here? 25. Oh, it's out there by the Jericho. So this is a big old space station out here that is used to house a Javelin. Looks like it's right beside me. See that big old space station out there? Okay. I have no idea what I'm going to find here. Honestly, this is my very first one of these I've done. What I am going to do is, while we're flying, I'm going to read real quick. And I will read it to you, because we all know that you people can't read. Just kidding. Let's see. Been hunting down a particular parcel of data, and right when I get... Been hunting down a particular parcel of data, and right when I get a break, the ship gets attacked by this converted nine-tail... Uh-oh. Am I going to hit it? No, I'm not. Okay. Sorry about that. I thought I was going to run into it because I saw the cloud. Go back. Where were we? Been hunting down a particular parcel of data, and right when I get a break, the ship gets attacked by this converted nine-tails reclaimer called the Black Kite. I tried to hack into the servers on the Black Kite to see if they copy the data, but couldn't find a way to remotely get past their encryption protocols without the physical key. That's where you come in. I need someone to breach their ship, get a hold of their decryption key, and decrypt the server so I can remotely pull down what I need. You're smart enough to know who we're dealing with here, but plan accordingly. Since it's going to ruffle some powerful feathers, let's not leave anything to chance. Destroy the Black Kite when you're done to cover both our asses. Oh, man. I've never done this. So, you guys are about to see me either be the most genius operator in the verse, or else I am going to get my butt handed to me. I do not know which one. Those two are working. Those two are working good. Flying to my destination. I get a little bit of coffee.
It's coffee time! Coffee!
Kind of excited about this, actually. Kind of excited. Oh, here, while we're flying, I'll give you another look at the ship here. Of course, it doesn't do so good. Let me roll it a little bit so you can... roll it the other way. So you can actually see it in the sunlight. There you go. So this one here is the Aurora Northwind, and the other one I showed you earlier was the Mustang. So this one's got two guns here, and two guns back here. One second, folks, be right back.
Sir underscore Henning said, 07 Medrunner stopping by to say hi. Sir underscore Henning said, are you muted?
Yeah, I'm very, very sorry about that,
Henning said, Sir Henning. Okay.
My wife and my folks, neither one, respect the fact that what I'm streaming and just call me and text me anyways. They don't care. I'm like, you do realize I'm streaming, right? She's like, no, you're not. It's not a big deal. I'm like, no, I'm in the midst of streaming right now. I just had to put myself on mute.
Sir underscore Henning said, All good.
She's like, you're fine. They don't care if you're talking to me. Wives, right? Thank you so much for stopping by, Sir Haining. Very, very much appreciate it. Hopefully you did hear the welcome song there as I played it for you while I was muted. I am in the midst right now of going to a derelict, or maybe not derelict, reclaimer. I'm going to a reclaimer. You know what?
Sir Haining said, yes, I did.
I'm sort of thinking maybe now that I am woefully unprepared for what I'm about to come across. That maybe I should have brought something a little bit larger, with some more firepower. We'll see. I got four S1s. What does one need more than four S1s, right? With four S1s, you can do anything. Anything at all. So hopefully in just a moment, I am going to try something that I've never done before. Okay, I see the ship. No, I see some asteroids. I see a small nebula and some asteroids. I'm seeing more asteroids. See, I don't know. I know the contract says something about a reclaimer, but I don't know if there's going to be, like, ships all swarming around it, or do I have to FPS from asteroid to asteroid? I have no idea what I'm about to do, and I'm not going to lie to you, chat, when I say I could not be more excited. I absolutely could not be more excited right now, because this is... This is beautiful. So beautiful. I love new content. Eat it up with a spoon. Okay, so I'm going... Oh, that's a whole lot of asteroids. These pirates are smart. They're close to the Jericho. Jericho's somewhere back there. Up there? No. They're close to the Jericho, while at the same time kind of keeping their anonymity, being out here in this little itty-bitty asteroid cluster. I think when I get about 40 kilometers out, I'm going to go ahead and slow down to a decent speed so I can sort of approach this and figure out what exactly it is that I am dealing with as I get closer. Hopefully, hopefully I'm not going to make myself a giant, what is it, the L? Oh, no, I need to go this way so you guys can actually see it on stream. There you go. Hopefully I will not be a gigantic loser. Zahur. We're going to see what happens. I've traveled to the last known location. Go me. What is my next job? Scan. Okay, I need to scan. So I'm going to go ahead and switch into scanning mode here and do some scanning. Oh, no, I think they meant ping. Let me try pinging. I'm going to go in a little bit farther. Pinging all the way. Ping, ping, ping. Now I'm going to start backing off because I'm about to enter this cluster. It said, so it said scan, not ping. So let me try pinging from here. See what this does. I got something over here. That is the black kite. Okay, so I have now found the black kite another 50 kilometers away. Go me. Guess I don't need scanning mode anymore. Now let's see what happens. Before we do this, I need to ask a question here. Let's ask the Ouija board. Will I make this? See what it says. Oh, I spelled it wrong? I did spell it wrong. Well, that's just silly. Oh, and now I have to add an extra A. Holy crap. End of day and I can't spell. No? No. I'm still doing it wrong. I do have this right, right? Try like this. Last time. No. Oh, there it goes. Now it's going to give us an answer. See, I'll fly a little bit forward while it's telling me. It is telling me to... Whip will fix it. The hell does that mean? I don't know what that means. Does anybody know what whip will fix it means? I've already located it. Hey, chat. Prepare yourselves as I either do great or horrible, and I don't know which one. Something behind me. Please don't tell me I'm supposed to disable this thing. It starts firing at me. Because this reclaimer is large. If you're not a Star Citizen player, it's large. Like, large. Compared to this thing, absolutely large. So if I'm required to disable it before I can get into it, I am so screwed. Maybe they don't know I'm coming. Shh. Okay. Yep, I located it. What's next? Board the black kite. I'm on the bottom or the top? I'm on the bottom. Now, where am I supposed to board it at? I board through one of the airlocks. I think what we're going to do is we are going to locate one of the airlocks real quick here. There's one right there. Okay. I'm going to go at a turret there and a turret there. I'm going to go right down underneath here. Spin my ship. Hopefully nothing can attack me here.
Engine stall.
Ooh, this is a little scary. I like it. Okay, let's go ahead and exit left. There's the airlock right there. In a pretty good spot here. Don't think they can shoot my ship from here. Retrieve data, reclaimer, ship name. Find the decryption key. I'm just gonna try going forward. Screw it. See if we get lucky. Hey, one thing, these criminals have done a number to this thing, haven't they? Okay, so this is their bunking area. Nothing there. Nothing there. What do you think, chat? If you were a decryption key, would you be on somebody or would you be in something? Give me a hand here. I've been thinking about maybe buying a reclaimer. I own the Vulture, which is the single person salvaging ship. I thought about buying a reclaimer. I still haven't decided if I'm going to or not yet. Captain's quarters. Encryption key. Check that out. Woo! Insert the decryption key into the server. What server? This server? You know, I think for right now I'm going to go ahead and store this. Just so I am good. Okay, these are definitely servers, but I don't think these are the servers I'm supposed to be going to.
M8_4_life_4EverSaid. It's on Anthe floor.
You just scared the crap out of me. And no backseat driving.
M8_4_life_4EverSaid. Sorry, buddy.
I want this MSR model. I want to take that with me so bad. Is there anybody on here? So far, I don't see anybody. I mean, don't get me wrong. It's not like criminals are the best kept people. Holy crap, this place is nasty. I'm going to set up real quick here. Oh, got my first chest ready. Make sure. Nobody in the drone room.
M8_4_life_4EverSaid. Good to see you have call to arms on.
Always. It is the very first thing that I do. There's the gravity generator. The very first thing that I do when I log in the game. What do you think, chat? Think I'll have anybody on the bridge? Really? I'm sure there'd be somebody down here. You mean tell me entire reclaimer there's one criminal? Yep, one criminal. I should just take the ship and leave with it. That'd be the easy way to do it. Yeah, I run with cold arms on. Oh, what the hell? I think I just died. I did. I got killed by an elevator. Come on. I've now lost 4 suits of armor today. at some point, I'm going to start taking this personally. Minor injury detected, left leg tier 3. Thanks. I've been regenerated. Thank you for that. The good news is your leg's no longer broken. That's the good news. The bad news is you've now lost your fourth set of gear today. Or you've lost your third. You know what? Just let me out of bed. And what's a guy got to do to keep his gear? I brought six sets of gear up here. I'm now down to 3. Hopefully, though, I'll be able to actually recover my... Hopefully, I'll be able to recover my other body with all the gear on it. I hope. I think I'm gonna take my defender with me. That way, I'll have something I can put it on there and get it all back off. Bear with me, chat. I'm getting there. I swear. Did I put? I did not. Did I have some done here? I do not. They're all up here. One of those, one of those, one of these. Two of those. Three of these. And what are these? Four of those. Okay, good to go again. Hey, this place looks familiar. Deja vu. I feel like I've been here before. Again and again and again.
Welcome.
I might as well call back the
ASOC vehicle retrieval system to the following location.
Bye. Might as well call back the ES. Because there's no reason for it.
Welcome to the ASOC vehicle retrieval. Your insurance claim has been sent.
Wait, do I still
Please
have the... Yes, I do
again.
Still have the quest.
Okay. Welcome Bye. To the ASOC vehicle retrieval Bye. System.
No, 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 no. No. Ugotana.
Vehicle selected. Stand by. Your vehicle has been delivered to
Please
the following location.
Again.
All I know is I've learned in the last 2 days of playtime that I need my C1 spirit to be released. That's all I'm going to say. It is the ship I've been missing from my fleet. Really honestly is.
Hello, how can Miss help you today? Systems on.
You can help me by getting out there. Wait, do I even know where the... Well, I at least sort of know where I'm going.
Oh,
the wing. Watch the wing. I am headed to...
Thank you, and please visit again.
It's my go one end. We need to go my go one. So let's go ahead and... Actually, I guess technically what I can do is I can go to my go one and click Jericho. So maybe can I... Yep, there we go. That's better. Oh, I should have left my other ship there, because my other ship would have worked as a beacon for me to know where I was going. Yep, yep, yep. So Northwind, this one here, this is called the Reliant, and pretty much what it does is it goes both vertical and horizontal. The ship does. It's a neat ship. It's one of my favorites, actually. One of. Little ship. This one here is the military version, so this one here has a bunch of weaponry and a whole bunch of missiles. I mean, like a whole bunch. I guess while I'm flying, I can go ahead and catch up with all this. Mobile factory, perfect for anyone who's trying to kick off their own manufacturing empire. Huh. The mobile cargo crafting vehicle. Oh, wow. Looks like there's going to be a Luminalia skin this year for the Avenger, which is kind of cool. There. Do not see the marker for my contract. It bothers me a little bit. Aha. I do see him. Do see a marker for my body? I'll take it. What did we learn, class? Don't explore the ship. Elevators are dangerous. That's what I learned. Cool. Just stays able to travel right back to it. I have a feeling my wife is home. My wife home? Oh, maybe I was wrong. Tonight is a good night, because tonight she makes her domicile famous pumpkin chili. Which is so good. Holy crap, it's so good. She always waits till this time of year to start making it, makes it throughout the entire winter. Gonna be some good stuff. cloud. Please don't let there be an asteroid. Please don't let there be an asteroid. Okay, that's better. The cloud was thick. I don't see anything else on my radar, so I think I'm still pretty good. My body stayed on the elevator.
Landing gear down.
Okay, so this time, I think we'll go this way. I'll line up right here along the... Okay, Google, stop. Off just a tiny bit, just in case.
Engines off.
Oh, I'm drifting. No, I'm drifting. How much am I? No, I'm drifting too much. By the time I get out of here, it may be halfway. Oh, that's my wife coming home.
Contact received. Engines on.
Okay, no drifting this time. That's better. No drifting is good. Fully dressed. Yep. Got everything I need. Yep. And off we go. Last time I went through the other airlock, this time I went through this one. Shouldn't have anything to worry about. That's the dogs playing. That kind of scared me a little bit, I ain't gonna lie. Is it me or does my body seem like it's at the bottom again? My body does seem like it's at the bottom, doesn't it? Oh man, do I go down and get my body? I gotta try, right? I need to do this time is I need to nope. Easy does it there, mister. There we go. Okay, so no other way for me to get out of here other than that elevator right there. Question is, does that elevator work? Or do I try this elevator again? And maybe, you know, I'm gonna try this elevator again. I'm just gonna go over here like this. Kneel down so my legs don't get hurt. Aha! I also have to remember that this body here is the one that has the key on it. Hello, my love. This is my body that I'm carrying with my other body. Please don't ask why I have two bodies. What's dropping? Welcome to Star Citizen. These are the kind of things you do. Things like carry your own dead body around. That door closed. Edge just for a second. Oh, don't float away. Don't float away. Okay, now that I've done this, now what I can do is I can loop myself. Find the data encryption Dumaflachi that I'm after. I'm going to guess is going to be in here. Move that. Into here. I've got the data encryption key. I'll take all this stuff. Side of the backpack. What I'm doing is I'm gathering up all the gear off my body, and I'm going to move all that gear over to my ship. What I will do is I will grab this, throw it in here, backpack, chest, arms, legs, helmet, and suit. Then, once I've done, suit. Oh, the wrong thing. There's not enough space in my ship for my suit, really. They must have really changed how much stuff you have left in these ships. Now I'm going to take this body. I'm going to give it a space burial. Bye-bye, other me. Oh, is he coming back? Wait. No. That's not allowed. Out there. That's better. Okay, so now I have... So as long as nothing else goes wrong... I got all my gear to go back with me. Back inside I go. I now have the encryption key, which is awesome. That was not what I wanted to do. That away. Now, can I take this other encryption key? And I can. Cool. I now have the other encryption key on me. Let's continue what we were doing. We'll go down here first. Nope, don't turn that on. It's the power plant. The server's down there. We go. Okay, so we got to take the elevator somewhere. Don't know exactly where, but we got to take the elevator somewhere. Are you talking to me, Peanut Butter Gallery? I have no idea. Don't actually look at that stuff. Why doesn't this thing have a... Salvage first. sort of feel like, Wait, stop moving. Some of them seem to be teleporting. Tell me these stairs are solid? I don't think I can look over stairs. I guess if I go around this way, I can. And this is why we went to the salvage balcony first, folks, right here. I can do things like that. Wait, where'd he go? Everybody dies! Everybody! Don't see anybody else. Elevator going down, but I can jump over that onto that, down and down, down like that, I believe. Let's try that out. We do a little bit of hardcore parkour. Maybe, maybe not. Hey, maybe not. We're not going to do hardcore parkour because you're not allowed. Says me. We're gonna go to salvage processing. I believe that's where we're going next. I think that's where we just came, because habitation should be right here. There's habitation. This should be salvage processing, which is where I was just shooting into. Did it right. Hopefully everybody's already dead. I'm gonna just sort of sneak around doing my thing. All I need to do now is figure out exactly which one of these servers is the one, but I'm not gonna touch that until after I am done. Completely making sure everybody's dead. D-E-D dead. Are you just laughing at me? Thank God somebody gets my humor. Oh. I see you there, mister. You were trying to hide inside of things. Oh, actually you weren't. You were just standing between everything. Well, irregardless, you're dead. My guess is going to be it's this thing. What is that? That's somebody's burrito. No, I'm not eating somebody's burrito. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab this thing. Insert it into that thing. The black kite. The my question is, how exactly does one do that? Maybe I could go back to the power plant or something?
M8_4_life_forever_said. You got this.
Maybe this. I will store that for later. Thank you very much. And, oh, what is this? I will store that for later. Thank you very much. I gotta find something. Nope, that does not. Nope. It's all gibberish anyways. Nope. No. Oh, don't you eat that. You have no idea where those pirates have been. Oh, yeah, I got the description key back. Cool. I'll just go ahead. No, don't equip. Oh, I got another one of these. I'll store that one, too. Well, these people are disgusting. Just because you're a pirate doesn't mean you can't be a classy pirate, right? Nope, can't do none of that. I'm now looking for everything that looks like it's something that you should be able to interact with. Who is this guy at? I want to loot. Let me loot. I do like the Lamont Corvus undersuit. The problem is that I can't wear it. I mean, I can't put it in there because I'm too busy with my own crap. Yes, he's got a Lamont Corvus undersuit as well. No, he's got the Sabine. Oh, I love the Sabine so much. I'm almost willing to drop my... You know what? I'm going to drop my Force Flex Digital Camo. And I'm going to grab this Sabine. I do love the Sabine suit. I'll care... What? No. Give me the suit. Oh, I got you. Okay, I got to drop everything else. Uh-oh, I can't drop anything else. No! Area's too cluttered. You know what we do about that? You will not keep me from this Sabine undersuit. There we go. Now, where was I? I was taking your legs and throwing them on the ground, and your helmet on the ground, and I was stealing your undersuit. Ta-da! Now I've got a Sabine undersuit. I would grab more, but... Nope. Wait, what was that? What was that? Ooh, another one of these. I will store that. Store it. And I will store that. Hope they don't expect me to get in the pilot seat and... Use the self-destruct function. Because I don't know if I can make it back to my own ship in that amount of time, can I? Okay, mate. If you don't mind giving me a little bit of a hint about that, I would appreciate it. I don't want to lose my own ship. Because if I have to do the whole use the self-destruct from the pilot's chair,
M8_4_life_forever_said. Use your ship to blow it up, buddy.
I should be able to shut down the... Ooh, what's over here? I should be able to use the pilot's chair to shut off the shield system. Nope. Bunch of jerks. Way to go up above? There is not. No. Good job, CIG. You guys did a good job. Make me think there's something back here. Is there something back there? That is a weapon. Okay, there's a way. Aha! Secret found! Grenade launcher. Or, oh, that's my force flex undersuit. It fell from up there somewhere. May end up having to get me one of these. Ah, that was the only box you could move. Okay, so this is what I'm going to try to do. I'm going to try to go back up front. I am going to turn off the shields. Wait. Is there anything in the... I haven't gone to look at the cargo hold. Maybe there might be some more stuff in the cargo hold. Maybe. This mission's awesome. I like this mission. This would be a lot of fun with friends. Although there would need to be more bad guys in here. Just having one bad guy. Oh, sorry. Well, I guess there was like four or five. But... And they were very, very easy to kill. Confused. I am now don't understand what's going on here. I found the one spot of the ship that the gravity generator doesn't reach. It's only from the on the ground, not up here. Okay, that's fine. Whatevs. Take me to habitation. I can't remember what the countdown or what the self-destruct timer is on this thing. Isn't it 30 seconds or a minute because of its size? I'd love to be able to use it like that, you know, start the countdown timer and get the hell out of Dodge. But I know that you're right, that I should just use my my own ship. But it would be awesome to like get in the pilot seat, start the self-destruct countdown, and then run for your life as fast as you can. You know, get out of here, get your ship in the way as it blows up.
bioassist activated. Systems green.
And you... Our items.
M8_4_life_forever said, it would be cool if they gave you the time to do that to get from here to there.
Yeah. I do not know. You know, I'm just going to shut the power off for everything. Screw it. I don't know what the power plant is on this thing.
Systems offline. Low power to shields. Low power to weapon systems. Low power to engines.
Now it's all shut off. Now it should blow up quickly and easily. Just in case. I stood here last time without dying, so I'm gonna try that again. Oh, and it worked. Look at that. Woo! I wonder how long it's going to take me with my little Tana to destroy this thing. Now that I've shut off the... What? Why did I just... I'm trying to be a nice guy and not let all the air out. Meanwhile, my intention is
M8_4_life_forever said. Hey, lol.
What can I say, man? I'm a nice guy down to the core. Even to the pirates, I'm still a nice guy. Even though I'm going to destroy their ship, still a nice guy. Nice guys can't change their stripes. I don't know what to say. Okay, we should time this, because this is going to take a while. No. Get the hand out of my...
Engines on.
There's a ship back. What a horrible place to have your hand.
M8_4_life_forever said, I'm bug.
Yeah. That's the Aurora. There we go, there's the black kite. Okay, so hopefully... Target's not friendly. It was full of pirates. That's why I killed them all.
Caution. Target friendly.
Am I even hitting it now?
Caution. Target friendly.
I don't think I'm hitting it anymore. You know what else we have in this ship? We've got not decoys. Pointing the right one. Can't remember what my stupid... Why is my ship not turning right? Oh, because I did this. But not this. I can't remember which one of my things flips. Hold on one second. My yaw and this arm thing in front of me is driving me insane. Absolutely nuts. Go, 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 go. The old and gray. That's missile operator mode. Yep, I knew that. Scanning mode. Ping. Mining. Oh, this one is swap yaw roll. Okay. Why am I not green? I'm in the area. It is not allowing me to...
Caution. Target friendly.
Did they all hit or not? Hitting.
Caution. Target friendly.
Target is friendly, but target is really taking a long time to die. It's a hell of a lot easier to be able to aim these things, you know, if I can, actually see. Oh, I'm missing. Crap. Now what am I going to do? Now what is my missile change? Missile. Let's panic. Power. Oh, cycle. Okay, that's what I wanted. I need this one. There we go. I got four of those. And it was locked. Have you been hitting? I've got a sound effect for this. Hold on one second, where is it at? It is... where's my sound effect for this one? This one, right here.
One eternity later.
This wouldn't be half as bad if I didn't have an arm in front of me.
Target friendly. Caution. Target friendly.
There it went. It took long enough.
M8_4_life_forever_said. Boom.
That took forever. And I got 50,000. So 7.5 hours later, I made 50 grand. Woo. Okay, so all I'm going to try to do now. Hey, look at
M8 _4_life_forever_said. GG, though.
Thanks. Right now, I'm just going to try to get back to Microtech and back to Port Tressler, where I will then probably camp off for the night. It is already 6:30, and as I said earlier, my wife is making her very famous amongst our peers pumpkin chili. And I am going to gobble it all up. Wait all year for the pumpkin chili.
It's coffee time! Coffee!
M8_4_life_forever_said. That sounds so goo.
It is.
Ood.
It is. Ood. Ood. Screw your arm. See, I actually set my track IR so that it wouldn't let me go side to side, or else I could have looked around my own hand. But whatever. What are you going to do? Some days, you've just got an arm in your way, you know? This is one of those days. Although I don't know exactly what I'm going to do as far as... Aha! I could fly like that. You will not break me, arm. You know what I can do is I can just shut it off right there.
M8_4_life_forever_said. This is safe. I will allow it.
Blame CIG, not me. Their fault for my broken arm. Not mine. I take zero responsibility in this. What I did though is I shut off my track IR5 when I pulled my head this way, so now I can actually see. The only part that's going to suck is landing. Everything else right now is just fine.
Victor_Hermesade stopped by to say hello. Driving home.
Hey man, what's going on? I am flying crooked. Oh, come on, look how close. I was so close. Wait. No. Right. Come on, OM5. Yep. We're getting there. Get there. How's your day, Victor? Okay, now we're gonna turn this way. Oh, there's Port Tress. We're getting this. I think we might got this, mate. Maybe. We're about to find out. Okay, so I know I need to turn around. I think I'm straight right now. I have no idea what my speed is, though. Am I moving? Now I'm moving. Crap, am I moving fast? Nope, now I'm moving fast. Okay.
M8_4_life_forever_said. Landing will be half the battle.
Half the battle. Oh. Slow down.
M8_4_life_forever_said. @Victor_Hermes, be safe going home, buddy.
Yeah, man, he's got it right. Be safe.
Victor_Hermesade. Good. Nothing to complain about. Getting ready to do more graphics for you all.
Come on, give me a spot. Come on, board gamer. I don't have time for this. But now I can't even see that. Oh, for God's sakes. So friends, be right about there. I don't know.
Please proceed to assigned landing bay.
Ah. Okay, so now I'm waiting for something. Great. So now I'm going to go ahead and do this.
Landing gear down.
Okay, here we go. Let's see exactly how good of a pilot I am. Think. No. Right there. That should be straight. That's straight right there. Made it in the hangar. Okay. Says that's zero right there. I'm just gonna let Autoland take care of it.
Landing complete. Have a pleasant stay.
Cool, got that part.
M8_4_life_4EverSade. Nice.
Oh, come on. I actually got the right button and everything. You're not going to... you know what? Screw you. Don't care. Sit here half broken, see if I can care. I'm not dealing with your junk. But at least I only ended up losing 3 suits today. I'm super, super excited about that. Because I get to put all this part back from that suit, which means, technically, I only lost 3 today. Like I said, that makes me super happy. Wait, what happened to my new fancy undersuit I got? Oh man, it kept it from me? No, that's in my own inventory. That's right, that's in there. Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this, put it in
M8 here. _4_life_4EverSade. Is it your bag?
Yeah, it was in my own bag. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take off my own gear real quick. You know, I can do this outside. I don't have to do this in here. I'm going to try the Sabine undersuit and see if it looks better or worse with the gear that I'm wearing right now. I love that weapon. That weapon is so cool looking. Isn't it? That weapon is so amazing. Love that thing. Okay. Here's what we're going to do. I need to strip naked real quick. I will strip
M8_4_life_4EverSade. That looks sick.
Yeah, it really does. And it shoots purple. Which, I mean, come on. You just can't get any better than that. You just can't. And undersuit. Okay, so Sabine undersuit. Kind of cool. Okay, let's go and layer. Doesn't look bad. I like it. It'd be this weapon here. Thought it was that weapon. Yeah, I don't think the Sabine undersuit looks bad at all. Kind of neat to have a little bit of white on my thighs. Not too shabby. Oh, I do have everything on. Okay, everything's on. Yes. No, I'm missing one. Am I missing one? I am missing one. wonder where that went to. I don't remember using a... I don't remember using a med pin in there, but me. What do I know? Okay, so I am all reset up. I am good to go. Got everything I need. Yes, I believe. Oh, I'm good to go for tomorrow. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so very, 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 very much for joining me. This was my first day actually back to streaming for the entire day. It felt really, really good. Can't promise I'm going to stream every day. Can't promise I'm going to stream as many hours as I did today. But other than the shout out for somebody earlier, everything else looked good. Actually, you know what I'm going to try real quick? Mate, you stream, don't you? Or at least have a streaming channel. I need to look. I need to try something out.
Welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
Before I go. What was this? Tana? Tana. Where's the tire? It is.
M8_4_life_4EverSaid. Yes.
Cool. I'm going to see if this works. Okay. I'm supposed to have a video shout out. So let's do VSO face mate. For life, forever. If it works, I don't see. Well, that's not working proper. It's supposed to do a shout out for you, and then when it does a shout out for you, it's supposed to also bring up a clip that you have. Yes, see, neither one of the shoutouts is working. Okay, so I got to work on the shoutouts. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna go ahead and call that a day. I will be back tomorrow, I think. Tomorrow's what, Thursday? I might be back tomorrow streaming again. If I am, the easiest way to find out is to click on the follow button, and that will give you a notification when I go live. I also do it on Twitter. So anytime that I go live, you can actually find out.
M8_4_life_4EverSaid. Have a good night. Thanks for streaming today.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it so much. I will speak to you guys tomorrow. And as always, be kind to one another, treat each other with respect, and I will catch you on the flip side. Ciao for now.
Zuwalsid, recharge imminent. Initiating ZZZ.X. If you want to make sure you catch the action next time, follow me on Twitter @https.